Hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Shooking. Many of you have been asking me for a recipe of lasagna without using oven. Today, that's what we are cooking. Let's make lasagna in a pan. Sleeves up, and the first step in the recipe is to make the lasagna sheets. Yes, you heard that right. We'll make the lasagna sheets at home for this recipe. For that, here I have about 1.5 cups of plain flour, which is Maida. To this, I will add in about 1 teaspoon of salt and about 2 tablespoons of oil. Now I will mix the oil and salt together and then add in a little water at a time and make a soft dough. Now you can see the dough is formed. I will divide the dough into small portions. I will divide it into 4 portions today. Since we are cooking it in a pan today, we will be making round lasagna sheets, so 4 portions is good enough. Now cover the dough with a damp cloth and let it rest for about 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, we will take a rolling pin and a base, and I will sprinkle a good amount of dry flour or maida into the rolling base. Take a portion of the dough and then start rolling it. You can also roll it in your platform if you want to. Since we have to make a very thin pasta sheet, for that we will have to sprinkle a lot of dry flour in between, so keep adding it and keep rolling it. Here you can see I have rolled my lasagna sheets and it is in the size of the pan. So this is the pan that I am using today, it is in this size. You can also cut the lasagna sheets into rectangular strips for making it in an oven like we get in the market, it's totally your preference. The pasta sheet is ready, now we will dry it. For drying the pasta sheets, we will dry it in a rack. You can also keep it on top of a cloth or a paper if you want to. This rack is from my oven. Now I will make more lasagna sheets like this, and we have to dry the lasagna sheets until they are slightly firm and translucent. For me, it takes about 30 minutes under a fan for the lasagna sheets to dry. Now to make the filling for our lasagna, which is basically sauteed vegetables, we will heat up a pan. Today I am using this hard titanium plus pan from Tefal. So this pan comes with a unique thermospot in the center, so that will turn red once the pan is hot and ready to cook. Super cool, isn't it? It's red now. I will add in about 2 tablespoons of oil to this pan. I'm using olive oil. You can also use refined oil if you want to. Since the pan is hot and ready, we will add in the chopped garlic to it. Here I'm using about 2 tablespoons of garlic. I will also add in about 1 teaspoon of chili flakes and about 1 teaspoon of oregano. We will cook the herbs in low flame for about a minute or two. That will ensure the herbs release all their flavor in the oil, which will bring out a very nice flavor to the recipe. Wait a second, many of you keep asking me why do I use metal utensils in a non-stick pan. As per popular belief, it can like scratch the surface and the coating can leach into food. Guys, good quality pans are very durable like this one from Tefal and are resistant to metal utensils. Now let me use it. Back to the pan, you can notice how the garlic and herbs have started releasing their flavors already. We will add in the veggies right now to this. You can use vegetables of your choice. Today I am using onions, a little bit of carrots, some French beans, a little bit of corn, and about 2 potatoes. We will stir fry the vegetables for about 3 to 4 minutes in high heat. The vegetables look good. Now I will add in the salt to this. Along with the salt, I will also add in yellow chili powder. You can also use black pepper or even red chili powder if you want to. Give the salt a mix and you will start to notice how the vegetables have started to release a lot of moisture. At this moment, we will add in the greens to this. Today I am using spinach and a little bit of coriander leaves. The next step is to cook the vegetables until they are dry, and we can toss them as well. So cook this in medium flame for about 2 to 3 minutes. Notice how I can toss the vegetables right now. They are very dry and the vegetables are ready. I will turn off the flame and take them down to a bowl. We will wait for the vegetables to cool down a little bit. The vegetables and the sheets are done. I have also grated some cheese. Here I'm using processed cheese. You can also use mozzarella or cheddar cheese if you want to. I've also got some marinara sauce, which is basically pizza sauce which I've watered down. You can watch my earlier video to see how to make pizza sauce at home. I've just added a lot of water to it and given it a mix. I've also made some white sauce. It's pretty easy to make it. You can watch my earlier video to see how to make it. Cool, these are done. Now we'll get back to the lasagna sheets that we made earlier. You can notice how they have dried a lot and are very firm now. And it looks sort of translucent as well. So they are ready to cook, and that's right, you don't have to boil it. They are ready to use. To make the lasagna, I'm using the same pan from Tefal. It is very durable, as I said earlier, and the heat distribution is very even, which will make sure our lasagna cooks evenly without burning. Plus, it has a titanium coating which will ensure nothing sticks to the pan. So the first step to assemble the lasagna is to take about 1 ladle full of marinara sauce and spread it in the pan. Now we will place a lasagna sheet on top. Now repeat the sauces. You can go in with some white and some red. I will next add in the vegetables to it along with some cheese. To make it slightly more cheesy, I am also adding a little bit of white sauce on top. Guys, there is no hard and fast rule to assemble a lasagna in a particular sequence. You can assemble it as you like it. Now I will just repeat the steps. Just make sure there is a little bit of sauce around the sheets. So over the last layer, I will add in a little bit of everything, that is a little bit of sauces, a little bit of cheese, and a little bit of vegetables, and spread it around. The lasagna we assembled is ready to cook. Now we will heat up the pan in low flame and cook it for about 20 minutes. After about 10 minutes, you can notice how the cheese is melted. It is halfway done. We will just spread the cheese along with the sauces and the vegetables. Because the cheese won't get brown, it's better to spread it around. After about 10 more minutes, our lasagna looks absolutely perfect. It is ready. It takes about 20 to 25 minutes to cook it in low flame. Now we will take it out. Lasagna made in a pan like this is best served after about 20 minutes, but if you cannot wait like me, sprinkle a little bit of red chili flakes and a little bit of chopped coriander and dig in. You can cut the lasagna into any shape that you like. I am cutting it using a turner. Basically, it's a spatula, metal spatula, cutting it, using it and serving it. See the layers, doesn't that look perfect? Can you believe it is made without using oven in a pan? So here is my lasagna, let me try it. The lasagna sheets are absolutely perfect and very well cooked. The flavors of that marinara sauce and the white sauce is absolutely fantastic, and it is very cheesy. And the best part is, it is very evenly cooked. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope to see you in my next one. Please do try out this recipe and share with me how it goes for you. Do remember to click the subscribe button and ring the bell icon beside it so that you get notified as soon as I post new videos on the channel. Bye.